Hey, good morning and happy Harness Your Hump Day. I am Tom Harness, owner and president of Harness Digital Marketing, located here in beautiful downtown Carterville. It's always a great time to start Wednesday off with my Harness Your Hump Day, and I'm going to give everybody a chance to hopefully get connected here and get online, because today's topic is going to be business-to-business collaboration with social media. That's going to be the biggest thing that we're going to talk about, and it is so important. So before I get started and we get some people on here, I've got to have my first cup of coffee, which is in my WSIU NPR powered by cup, thanks to my buddy Brian Flatt. I hope everybody's morning is off to a great start. We've got a lot of great discussion to talk about today when it comes to business collaboration. Bunches of ways to look at it and view. Bunches. Oh, man. All right, so let's get started. When we talk about business-to-business collaboration, what we're really talking about is two businesses or two organizations working together to mutually benefit one another. We tend to forget that when we have this business-to-business collaboration, it always sometimes feels like it's one-sided or the other-sided. And when we're doing this, we need to have great communication, and we need to be able to express what our goals and what our needs are for the other person. So when we put this out on the table, what we want, we clearly state it, and then we make sure that we execute that and have some way to measure it so we can go back and say, was this business collaboration beneficial for not only you, but I'm going to share with you how it was beneficial for me. When we're working with a lot of things, good morning, Susan. When we're looking forward to doing these business collaborations, you have to remember that it's not one-sided, like I said. It has to be literally mutually beneficial. When we have it that way, what happens is beauty happens. When you have two businesses collaborating that are able to work together towards a common goal and both parties win, it's great for the consumer. It's also great for everybody involved. Now, I ramble a little bit, so let's talk a little bit more specifically about what that looks like. Now, when we as a business, Harness Digital Marketing, wants to do a partnership, whether it is with WSIU or whether it is with our latest partnership with Withers Radio and Dana Communications, when we have those, we have to clearly state what our intentions are, what our goals are, and what theirs are. So when we have that, we can find creative ways then through social media to enhance that collaboration. So typically we talk about advertising, and advertising is when we're going to say we're going to place something out here and it's going to have your name and that's great. But in the digital world, it's amazing, because if you have those partnerships with TV, radio, newspaper, whatever it might be, you've got content. And remember, digital marketing, social media is about having content, and content that is worthwhile and mutually beneficial to all parties. So if we're promoting something we did through another business to help us, it's also indirectly benefiting the person that is advertising. For example, when we worked with WSIU, my good buddy Brian Flatt over there, this was a while back. When we worked on I think it was called The Startup. Brian can correct me on this. When you work with The Startup, the show was The Startup, we wanted to partner with them because we felt it was a good match between who we're going for as clients, and we could reach out to them. So every week, they would highlight new businesses. I would reach out to those businesses and see if they were interested. This was national. Now, on the same token, we have now formed a partnership with Withers Radio and Data Communications on the Stars and Stripes SI. Stars and Stripes SI is a group page, but we also have a radio component that they sell advertising to, and we highlight the businesses that want to support them, right? So it's mutually beneficial for all parties. I'm in there getting our name out there through the digital aspect, and I'm also promoting Withers on the radio. I'm getting promoted on them, but basically they're be able to make money and make basically kind of promote the other businesses that are sponsoring them. So those two things are great collaborations. What happens sometimes is, as business owners, what do? Here's my money. Here you go. I do what you got to do. Bring me customers. I have money out, money in. And that is a missed opportunity. Good morning, Jen. And Susan, yeah, I think it's because I don't have my coffee in me yet. And I apologize to everybody. I am trying to get a little more focused here, but I'm a little bit behind the curve. But those business collaborations, once they're established and business owners try to look at it as mutually beneficial, oh my gosh. Just don't hand off money for newspaper, TV, radio, digital marketing, social media. Find ways that you can collaborate with them. For a brief period here on Harness Digital Marketing, we had Blade Made. Blade Made was a sponsor. They contributed, and I plugged them. Great product, great service. They have a great story. We helped them out tremendously. And I unfortunately can't tell you how, but they had a big opportunity. And it was in part due to the excellent social media content, writing, and branding that Crystal did for them. And I'm very appreciative, and I wish them nothing but the best. Now, something else to consider when you're thinking about business collaborations: length and time. Sometimes it's good to have long partnerships. Sometimes it's good to have short partnerships. Whatever it is, clearly define what that partnership looks like. Don't make assumptions. Now, if you ever feel like it's one-sided or not, you need to reach out and say, listen, I love being associated with you. I'm partnering with you. I'm not necessarily seeing the outcome. Instead of just cutting money and cutting ties, lay it out there. What were you expecting? What did you want? Why did we not get that? A lot of times what I've found when you collaborate, when you regroup, you make it better and you continue to make that relationship stronger. When you lose communication, it's over. And there's no way to really recover from that. You've got to keep those lines of communication open. If you're not happy, discuss it. That's fine. But have facts. You can't just say, I don't like this. I'm not a fan of this campaign. Why? Right? That's the big question. Why? All right. So Susan or Jen, do either one of you have questions while we're on here about business-to-business collaboration? I'm sure, Susan, you do a lot of business collaboration. Jen, you do a ton of business-to-business collaboration with photography. I know you've got a big project coming up that you're kind of collaborating with as well. Now, I'm going to pick a little bit on Jen, and not because I want to be mean, but I want to use Jen as an example. Jen's an amazing photographer. She's been, well, literally all over the world. And her heart is bigger than her business model. And what I mean by that is she will give and give and give to any cause, whatever, at the detriment of herself and her business. So this is an example, and it's hard because her heart is bigger than her business model. And there's nothing wrong with that, but she has to pay bills. She has to be able to have a life. She's got a beautiful puppy. She's got things to do. And when we kind of condition people or businesses or organizations that our services are for free, guess what? We're devaluing ourselves and what we can contribute. Now, that doesn't mean we can't be generous and helpful. Not at all. And Jen does an amazing job at that. But Jen is like a lot of people that either start out their business for the first time or are in an industry where they want to get their name out. They think that branding all the time and getting out there will return money, when you have to have a mutually beneficial agreement between people. And there's creative ways to do that. You can still do free when it's not really free. You can get something in return, but you have to follow up on that and make it happen. Now, I hope Jen doesn't get mad at me because I love her. And I just wanted to point that out because usually we're pretty good friends, and I know she won't take it personally. I hope not. But I want you all to understand, business owners, individuals, solopreneurs, value your service. There's a balance between getting your name out there and getting free. Always have in mind mutually beneficial. Do not be afraid to ask for something that you want, that you need. At the end of the day, the business owner, you, the solopreneur, are the only ones responsible for paying your bills, paying your mortgage, your rent, your car payment, your kids' events, you. Don't ever be ashamed or afraid of that. Have the ownership of your business and combine your business plan with your heart, and you will be very, very successful. One of the things that helped me is I have a quota, whether it's money or free service, you can do it monthly, quarterly. Monthly is probably hard to manage. Quarterly would be fine. And otherwise, it's okay. One of the things I've noticed when I've said no, but I'll be willing to do this, like plug the event, just like mention it, that works too. Or sometimes what happens when people try to go always free, remember, you always get what you pay for. When they try to go the free route and it doesn't work out, guess what? Because you stood up and you showed that you have value, guess who's first in line when they come back? They're like, listen, I think we need to go ahead and pay. This is something that's worth paying, so let's go with this. Another option is discount services. You can discount, but you still have money and revenue coming in. Just remember those things when you're working on business-to-business collaboration. Very, very important. All right, let's see what we got here. Jen says she learned a lot from that. So far, good comments from Jen. She's not, you know, hanging up and getting rid of me. Growth the hard way. Yeah. Amen, Jen. And then Susan says, by the way, I have a 25, by the way, she has a 25% coupon for Eckert's for the next 2 days if anyone wants it emailed. Yes. All right, everybody remember that. And Jen, absolutely value myself now more than ever. Jen, there is nobody more valuable to society, to a community than you. Absolutely. So don't be afraid to stick to your guns and show value in what you do. Susan, anything else you want to add? You've been doing this for a while. Any business-to-business collaborations that you can think of that have worked or have been very successful? Let's see if she replies back here in a second. Oh, and I got some hearts from Jen. All right. Well, if you have any tips on business-to-business collaborations that have worked well for you, please post them down below. Let's share this. Let's help each other out. Let's grow the community, and let's make it better. Just a reminder, part of what I've mentioned was our partnership with Withers Broadcasting and Dana Communications. We have the Stars and Stripes SI page. It's dedicated to veterans. It's about veteran businesses, veteran events, and businesses and people that support veterans. So if you want to be a part of that community, go to Stars and Stripes SI, join, and let's make that community grow. And let's show Southern Illinois we love our vets. Also, Leaf Food Hub. You need some fresh food? Need any fresh food like chicken, beef, bagels, plants, herbs, mushrooms, whatever it might be? My friend Liz DeRuntz, who head, and I think she's the executive director of the Leaf Food Hub, she can, if you want to reach out to her, she can work with you on getting fresh produce delivered to your location. You support local businesses and you can get it. They have a new location or new pickup location at in DuCoin at, oh my gosh, my brewery, St. Nicholas, almost forgot, at the St. Nicholas Brewery in DuCoin. That is now a pickup spot for some fresh produce. So those of you that are in DuCoin, there you go. All right, everybody, have a wonderful Harnesser Hump Day. And remember, Harnesser's Marketing here is to hashtag turn the light bulb on for your business and organization. And no matter what you do, go out and be the reason someone smiles today. All right, everybody, have a great one. And we'll see you next Wednesday.